Well, it's now time to turn to our second proposition, which is that the Electoral College should be amended or abolished. Dr. Loomis, you have 10 minutes to make the case.
I love the notion of Pittsburgh to the West Coast. There's a lot of truth to that. We've all seen maps. You've seen the maps of the 2000 and 2004 election. If you see those maps, you see blue slivers on the West Coast and some of the upper Midwest and Northeast Democrats, and a vast red for the rest of the country. And those square miles figures, absolutely right. No question about it. All those antelopes in Wyoming, well represented. I happen to live in the last blue county in the 2004 election for 600 miles. And we're damn proud of it in Lawrence, Kansas. I think that that what Gary describes is an issue. But you can see this red and blue America. We see it on CNN all the time. There's another map that exists, a map of the United States county by county. That's where I get the last blue for 500 miles. And in this map, what you see is there's some substantial blue and substantial red, but there's a heck of a lot of purple. There are a lot of Democratic counties in Texas. There's a fair amount of Republican counties in Massachusetts. You go to California, a very blue state. You go inland 60 miles, it's red. State after state is much more purple than it is either blue or red. What that means is that as we sum up these 50 states, winner take all in each state, each vote doesn't count the same. It doesn't even come close sometimes. So my proposition is very simple. The Electoral College should be replaced by a popular vote system, probably a pure plurality system, perhaps with a 40% threshold for a runoff for the top two candidates. The argument's going to come that this will ruin the two-party system. So far, every governor is elected exactly this way, with a plurality or a runoff. Every senator is. We have all Republicans, all Democrats. But the key here is, very simply, it's the equality of all voters, every one of them. The second point is that I honestly think, and we can't really prove something in the future or prove a negative, but I think it produces a clear national winner with less chance of testing the highly suspect mechanics of the Electoral College. So first of all, on the equality front, there is, I think, a systematic disenfranchisement of minority party voters in many states. I live in Kansas. The last time we voted for a Democrat was in 1964 with Lyndon Johnson over Barry Goldwater. I moved to Kansas in 1980. It's 1979. So I've participated in all the presidential elections. I'm a moderate Democrat. I voted Democratic in all of those out of some perverse sense of loyalty. My vote has never, ever mattered. Not once. Because everybody knew in every election from 1964 on that the Republicans would win that state without any doubt. The argument goes that maybe it's small states that are advantaged by the Electoral College. Maybe it's because they get this little bonus of a couple senators among electors. Maybe it's the large states like California, New York, that have so many votes, and it's all winner take all in every state. So you win California by one vote, or Florida by 535, and you get every every electoral vote. So really, in any given election over the last several, there are about 15 or so competitive states. In the other states, Kansas, among others, voters are simply disregarded by campaigns and candidates. So what if you had a popular election for president? The argument, oh, you'll only focus on the big cities. Not true. For one thing, you'll get much more national advertising because it's cheaper to advertise the nation as a whole than it is to 50 separate states. If you can make inroads in the state of Kansas, for example, this year, if Barack Obama is the nominee, he will run 5 or 7 points better than Hillary Clinton will run in the state of Kansas. No question about that in my mind. He still won't get to 50%. He still won't win the state, but he will produce lots of excitement. Why shouldn't that excitement, those voters who want to come to the polls and vote for Barack Obama, be rewarded by counting them all together? We've certainly have the technology to do that. That's really not an issue. I mean, the problems of counting the votes in Florida or California or New York are equal to the problems of counting the votes across the country. And I'm not really going to pick on the year 2000. I mean, it's this incredibly close election. If you have the Electoral College. If you don't have the Electoral College, it's a close election, but there's a clear winner. The clear winner is Al Gore. He wins by, everybody says he wins by more or less 500,000 plus votes. There's no ambiguity there. Now, let's get back to this notion of paying more attention to small states or to that the Electoral College encourages that. I mean, that's just baloney. In 2000, 18 states had zero visits from the presidential candidates. 18. In 23 states had zero visits from either one or zero visits from the presidential candidate. So in almost half the states, they got no visits. You think, oh, that's just 2000, very highly partisan election, red, blue. 1976, Gerald Ford versus Jimmy Carter. A couple of relative moderates, really. Southern conservative, a Midwestern traditional Republican. In 1976, 13 states received zero visits. 12 states received one visit from one presidential candidate to the other. So 25 states had one or zero visits. Half the states had one or zero visits from a presidential candidate. By no means can that be called a national campaign. I would submit and make a big bet that if we had a popular vote election, that presidential candidates would visit and campaign relatively vigorously in far more states. It's in their interest to campaign in every state. It's in a Democrat's interest to move his or her vote from 35% to 45% in Kansas. Even if they lose the election, there would be vigor there. There would be a 50-state campaign. Right now, the campaigns center in 12, 15, 18 states. I live right next to Missouri. I get to see a presidential campaign every year. They spend lots of money. They really focus on every corner of the state. The only reason we ever get to see anything in Kansas is because we get Missouri TV. Secondly, very quickly, I do think there's a clarity of result here. We've had the Electoral College has sometimes, often, exaggerated the scope of the victory, and that's supposed to be a positive. But honestly, people have not done very much with those results. Ronald Reagan won a huge victory in 1984 and really did nothing with it. Someone like Woodrow Wilson won a very scanty victory, an electoral college mandated victory in a three-way race in 1912, and did a lot with it. So I think that the idea that the Electoral College exaggerates the victory is problematic. And secondly, I think there is this clarity in a national election of 500,000 votes for Al Gore versus one vote on the Supreme Court.